Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. My name is Vieco, and today I want to share with you guys this one little trick or workflow in Corona Render that will tremendously reduce your render times, right? Just a quick note, I was talking to Vladimir Kuilazov, the person who wrote V-Ray, and he said that this method can also be replicated in V-Ray too, because the technology used is the same, right? Let me just show you how does the whole thing look like. So if I open up Photoshop, for example, I rendered this image that you see here. It was rendered in 2000 by 2000 pixel resolution. I rendered it in 51 minutes. Here, I have that same image, but rendered in 7 minutes. And this is the result. So 7 minute, 51 minute. 7 minute, 51 minute. Now get this, when I zoom in, for example, you see like the wood grain here, how it looks like? This is on the 51 minute image. And on the 7 minute, it looks much more clearer, much more sharper, much more pronounced, everything. Even if you look at, for example, the stitches here, so they here look kind of jagged, you know, when I click here, they're just super heavily defined. The same thing goes with, you know, the cloth here or the fabric, you know, this is 51 minute, you know, this is 7 minute. And now let's go to the technical part of this whole sorcery, right? I believe a lot of you use denoisers for your work. I was actually a super anti-denoiser in my career, but recently this one specific denoiser changed my mind, and this is why this video is dedicated to it. So a lot of you, I believe, use the Corona high quality denoiser because it's the default, because it says high quality and all of that. Corona high quality was actually high quality in the time when it was created, but over time new technologies developed and it got surpassed by these other denoisers. So if you go to, you know, the drop down list, you have the Nvidia GPU AI, you have Intel CPU GPU AI, and this video will be dedicated to Intel CPU GPU AI because it's ridiculously good. Now get this. For a standard workflow, you would have Corona high quality denoiser, you would have your noise level limit to like 3 to 5%, that's kind of the average that people use, and you would just go and render the image, and this is the image that I got, and the render time was 51 minutes and 15 seconds. My resolution is 2000 by 2000 pixels. So do this, open the project that you have, like an interior, exterior, whichever project that you have, and just follow what I'm saying right now. Change the denoising to Intel CPU GPU AI. Set the amount of the denoise to 0.85. I think default is 0.65, set it to 85, right? I personally do not use noise level limits because with this method, I've been gaining amazing results from noises that were like 15% of noise to like 40% of noise or 35% of noise. It was like extreme noise and this thing just pulled it out like a champ. It's stupid. Anyhow, I set my noise level limit to 0 and I pretty much just eyeball the minutes. So if an image was rendering for 1 hour, you can try and put here like 7 minutes or 5 minutes, just see what works best for you. So let's say 7 minutes here. Next, you need to go to the system. So in the system, image filter, you have to change that to 10th because Intel AI denoiser is trained on 10th filtering. Therefore, with 10th, it provides the best results. And now the final trick, which actually makes this a workflow kind of thing, go to your resolution. My final resolution here was 2000 by 2000 pixels. You want to double your resolution. So set that to 4000 by 4000 and click render. Now, I have a second max here where I already rendered this image. So I had, you know, my time to 7 minutes, Intel CPU, GPU, AI denoiser here, 4000 resolution. You can see that the time that it took to render was 7 minutes and 12 seconds in 4000 by 4000 resolution. So get this. Copy the image once it's done, right? As you can see, my noise level here was like 14%. It was like very, very big number. Go into Photoshop, and now with that double resolution, paste that image in, right? So this is the image from my 7 minute render. Go to image size and downscale the image. Downscale it by 50% so that you get your final output of 2000 by 2000 pixels. Press OK, and that's it. What happened now? let me just kind of dissect what did we do here so that you understand why this works the way it works, right? So Intel's denoiser is for some reason amazing. It does not like screw up textures, like all the objects are in place. I generally got the impression that it has a very, very large like quality. I was also talking to Tom Grimes, and he actually confirmed that he uses Intel AI Denoiser all the time for all the presentations, for everything, right? But now, here is the catch. Downscaling. What are you doing with downscaling? Since this is a denoiser, and, you know, if you have an extremely small, if you have extremely big amount of noise, you know, the denoiser cannot be perfect in all scenarios. It's going to start to cause some artifacts. And this is where we kind of, you know, screw it up. You render double resolution. And with that double resolution, you are pretty much infusing your image with four times more details. Therefore, you're giving the denoiser four times more information to work with, and because of that, you can have like tremendously big amount of noise, but you've given every scenario, you've given it like four times more data. And now, when the denoiser does its thing on that double resolution, it will probably do some sort of artifacts, but when you downscale them, that threshold for a mistake is much lower, therefore you're gonna get suddenly a super clean render. Downscaling, on the other hand, is this amazing technique that preserves kind of details in the image. It naturally sharpens your image and boosts all the details. So one example of that is, for example, I already did a video on that, but I remember there was this scenario where I had this like chrome tap in a bathroom, right? And I was rendering it in 2000 pixel resolution. There was some kind of highlight, you know, there. And I remember when I rendered it in double the resolution and then downscaled it in Photoshop, the highlight was perfectly preserved. Like all the details were there. Just one thing, I don't know if I mentioned it right now as I was talking, when you are on the image size and when you are doing the double down resolution, so this to 50%, make sure that the big cubic sharper reduction is turned on. This method is your kind of image resampling method. Right. But yeah, this is the result. I also, I've sent this to a couple of people. For example, this is the scene from the guys at Evermotion. They also rendered the image for 1 hour. I told them to render 7 minutes. So this is 1 hour version, and this is the 7 minute version. There are some slight tone shifting, but as you can see, no details are pretty much lost. As a matter of fact, the details are gained. So for example, if you take a look at this, this is 1 hour version now. You see how Helsinki and Oslo spells, and when I added the 7 minute version, you can see how it's all much more infused with detail. The detail letters are much nicely visible and all that. On the other hand, if you take a look at, for example, this plant, this is the 1 hour version, and now with the 7 minute version, it's just much more defined. Speaking of that example with the highlight on a tap, this is actually a good moment to show you this. This is a front panel here, and this is a shelf on top, and there is a tiny, tiny gap here. And you can see with 1 hour, that tiny gap is like badly, generally pixelated, like you barely see it. But look, with a 7 minute version that was downscaled, look how nicely pronounced this part is. And this is the magic of downscaling. On the other hand, I saw, I think on this whole image, like the biggest difference that I saw was in this glasses on the table. They had, you see, like something funky is happening with them. I have no idea what it is, but it doesn't bother me, meaning it looks equally good. Now, with this method, you are going to have changes in your scene. Some bumps, like on the wall, etc., might be a little bit lower, but nothing tremendously, you know, so that it causes issues. But what is the trade-off? You're going to get a much sharper image, you're going to get much more details everywhere, and you're practically going to get a, what is that, like 10 times lower render time. So yeah, try it out. Note for V-Ray users, when I said in Corona that you need to go to a system. So here, let me show you. So note to V-Ray users, in Corona, when I said that you have to go to system image filtering and change this to tint, in V-Ray, you don't have to do that. When you choose Intel AI Denoiser, it automatically applies the correct filtering for that. You don't need to search for this anywhere in V-Ray. And yeah, this is pretty much the trick. I really want you guys to try it out. I've tried it on interiors, exteriors, sci-fi scenes. It generally worked everywhere. I tried it with like 5 to 6 different people who have like completely different workflows. For all of them, it worked just fine. I even have one report of the dude who was trying to test how low the render time can go. And he was happy, like it was an image that was rendering for like 1.5 hours. He said that now his new render time is 3 minutes. There is some sort of trade-off, but the speed gain is brutal. So yeah, please try this out. I hope that it will save you some time. And as usual, thank you for watching and see you in the next video. Bye.